from?
Germany.
Huh?
German.
Huh?
German.
You're from German?
Hey guys, welcome back to another video. So tonight is kind of a different one. I decided we're gonna come out and hang out in the city. We're gonna come out here, we're gonna kind of see what the local people are doing. And the tourist people. I apologize, the stupid mask. But we're gonna go hit up the pier area. We're just gonna go see what the Western people are doing out here in Phuket in this area. If you know this area, I wanna show you guys what's going on down here. Now this is kind of the south part of Phuket. I guess it is touristy. You got a lot of stuff here. They got the best chicken, y'all. I think you guys are gonna like it. So we're gonna hit up all over there, just walking through a bunch of these restaurants and whatnot. You know, I get a lot of questions like, what do I like about Thailand? You know, I keep wanting to say 7 or 8 days, but it's been about 2 weeks now. And I gotta say, I really do like it. When I lived in Vietnam, the early times, I was a teacher. There's a lot of teachers that would compare Thailand to Vietnam. And I totally get it now, like why they were acting the way they were. Like Thailand is so calm compared to Vietnam. It's so quiet. Compared to Vietnam. It's a lot cleaner. Definitely a nice environment. They always hear about the DUIs. This is one thing about Thailand. I don't know if you guys saw that. Let me try to put another picture there. Is Thailand takes drinking and driving very serious. Or at least here in Phuket, there's a lot of checkpoints, like DUI checkpoints out here.
Hey guys, so I wanna break in the middle. I'm editing the video right now and I'm going through it. And I wanna pre-warn you guys, this is kind of a weird one. I don't post this in any disrespect. It is, I was intoxicated at a certain point, and the guy that I met was a little intoxicated. But I do find that this is a really cool interview. This guy's lived in Thailand for like 4 years, 6 months in Phuket. So he has a lot of good feedback, and he speaks fluent Thai, which is a cool thing. So he has a lot of good insight that I thought was kind of useful for a lot of people. And he also leaves his location. If you ever want to go meet him, grab a beer. He's a really cool guy to talk to. We even help you learn a little Thai if you want. But hit that like button if you do like these types of interviews, and leave a comment below if you do like these interviews, and I'll start doing more of them. I love doing them, but I don't know if you guys like to watch them. But either way, enjoy the interview. I will see you at the end of the video.
Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Today is a special video. I have met a French guy right here. This guy's lived here for 4 years. I thought it'd be kind of cool to kind of sit down and talk to him about what he thinks about living in Thailand for 4 years. He's always lived in, you live in Phuket?
To Phuket, no. I've been to Chiang Mai. Chiang Mai, Ayutthaya, Phuket, Thai, Chiang Mai, Chiang Rai. And my next plan is to go to Isan.
We're gonna talk about living in Thailand. And how long have you been in Phuket?
In Phuket, I've been 6 months already.
Okay, so let's focus on Phuket. Six months of Phuket. What is life like living in Phuket for 6 months?
And speaking Thai too.
And he speaks Thai. Give us up.
Sorry, ครับทุกคนนะผมชื่อต้วนนะครับผมมาจากผมเป็นคนฝรั่งเศสนะครับแล้วก็เรียนภาษาไทยมา3ปีแล้วนะครับคือแล้วก็เมื่อก่อนเคยเที่ยวที่กรุงเทพโดยไม่พูดภาษาเลยนะครับมีแฟนเราคบกัน7เดือนด้วยกันหลังจากนั้นก็กลับมาที่ฝรั่งเศสเรียนภาษาไทยและตอนนี้เนี่ยและตอนนี้ก็เที่ยวใหม่นะเที่ยวใหม่นะครับที่ไทยโดยพูดภาษาได้และพูดตรงๆเนี่ยก็มันสุดยอดเลยคนไทยใจดีมากนะครับตลกด้วยก็มันเปลี่ยนจริงๆเปลี่ยนชีวิตของผมนะครับ
Why should somebody come here and live here in Phuket, Thailand?
The bar I love the most is called Lucky Bar in Chalong. You can find easy.
Why you love that?
And I love that bar also because it's a family bar and small size. You can drink all night, no problem, and it's always like good time. So in Phuket, I enter in Phuket because of Sandbox first. I never know about Phuket before, and I want to go to Thailand. At that time, because of COVID, there was only like Sandbox open. There was also other programs, but Sandbox was the most easy, the easiest.Way to enter Thailand. So I came to Phuket. I have to say that when you know, coming, entering in Phuket, most of the people here, they friendly. There's a lot of Falang. It depends, of course, it depends on which areas you're going. If you go to Patong, for example, you'll get into the traps of Patong. I don't have to explain it. The most beautiful thing that I know about Phuket for now is the people, which I can talk with. Once you've been friendly with them, good-hearted people, if they can help, they will help. And it's fun too, you know, for example, I go to the family mart every day. I go to buy some food, I go to buy some coffee. And you know, the lady at the family mart, she always asks me, because she knows I'm single, when are you going to get a girlfriend?
If somebody was to come to Phuket, what are the top three reasons why they come to Phuket?
The beaches. The beaches are absolutely incredible, which is Nai Han Beach, Katap Karon Beach, Katanoi Beach. There's a lot of beaches which are absolutely incredible. You can get to chill there. The lifestyle is, you know, cool and relaxed. You'll be whatever you'll be doing. Sorry, you've been traveling or only traveling, or you'll be working here. You can go to the Big Buddha. You can go to see some tigers, monkeys. Really fun to play with. Top three reasons in which you want to come to Phuket. Before I'm going to keep going. I'm sorry for my English. It's not perfect. I'll try my best. Number one, atmosphere. In Thailand, you'll get into a great atmosphere, friendly, understanding atmosphere. You can come as you are. Respect you more if you're not faking and coming as you are. Number two, beaches. Beach are absolutely incredible. Nice, calm, can get to surf, can get to swim. Some people, you know, playing fires. You can get a massage on the beach as well. Absolutely incredible. It's nice. It's cool and relaxing. Number three, what are you looking for? You're actually looking for some different types of relationships. A relationship in which you would get out of your comfort zone. With Thai people and Thai culture, you'll need to. If you're ready for it, please come to Thailand. Three reasons why you should not come to Phuket. For me, that's a subjective perspective. That's a, you know, personal perspective. First one is you're looking for really to create deep and real personal relationships. Phuket is not the good place to do that. Why? Because even though some Thai people can speak English, Phuket is only about business.
What is the best experience you've had living in Phuket? How long have you been here?
Been 6 months already.
6 months already, okay. Where are you from originally?
France, South France.
You're from France?
Yeah.
That's cute.
I'm a sunny guy, I'm a beach guy. I like hot weather.
What is the one thing you hate about being here?
I would say the weather. I like hot weather. The weather is sometimes really hot. Sometimes it's raining, like cannot expect it, but just boom, raining really hard. Fucks up your plans. Like you want to travel at some beach or something, but cannot.
So you've been here for 6 months during the COVID thing. How's the COVID thing been for you, like living here? Like how's the process? And has it been hard? Or you've been stuck? Have you been having to pay like bribe money, or what's going on?
Not really. Like I'm working online, so I've been well. There's no COVID for me. As I haven't lost any relatives. I'm all right. COVID is only a money thing. I've been over it. Back in the COVID period, because we're not anymore, nothing was closed. You know, massage shop, the bars, the restaurants, like everything was closed. Like, you know, like it was boring.
Hey, did you get a girlfriend yet?
No, I didn't.
Oh, okay. I hope for you next time you get a girlfriend. You know, for example. So that's funny. That's friendly talk. And it's the same at the motorbike shop. It's the same at the bar. You know, it's only friendly, playing full. And I think Thai people are like this. They like to play, they like to drink, they like to have fun. The politeness and the attitude that you have when you're entering in a bar, in a restaurant, is that you have to be respectful. Not being rushy, not talking too loud, you know, just being like calm and just like, you know, talk sense, not talk nonsense. Thai people like that. They find a lot of respect in that. That's the only way, like, you know, just being yourself, just being respectful and calm, you know, in everyday life. Here you'll be in heaven. You'll be really nice. You'll be really good. Yeah, that's my message, I'll say.
So I've come from Vietnam. A lot of people that watch my videos are from Vietnam. We're gonna talk about three things. I want you to tell me the Thai version. Traffic in Vietnam is loud, chaotic, out of control. You cannot cross the street. It's constant honking. How is Thailand traffic?
It gets pretty busy from 5 until 7 or 8.
How's the noise? How's the safety?
You gotta be really careful because some people are parking. A lot of people are coming back from work. You're in a crowd of 20 or 30 people driving motorbikes, so you have to be really careful. Some people passing you by on the left, on the right, but nobody's, you know, how do you call that? Horning. Nobody's horning.
Nobody's horny.
Nobody's
horny.
After 8 p.m., everybody's horny.
This is a French translation of honk.
It's everybody's horny, you know, and horniness can take you really far.
Vietnam is a very polluted country.
It's actually number four in the world. How do you feel about pollution, street trash, noise?
Street trash and pollution, I haven't been to India. It's all right. There's not much pollution, not much trash. And people are pretty much respectful of nature, so it's all right.
How is it interacting with Thai people speaking their own language? Are they abrasive towards it, or do they kind of like treat you like you're like a little child? Like, oh my God, you speak Thai.
Traveling in Thailand, most of the tourists, most of the Falang cannot speak Thai. So most of them, when you first met them, they're gonna speak to you in English. Because they're gonna assume that you're not speaking Thai. They understand that you can speak Thai and you speak good Thai. I'm not talking about someone who's only uttering a lot of words, stuttering, because that would make the Thai, you know, pissed off. And it would be the same in the old language, like, you know. There will be a stranger, you know, uttering, and you have to pay him a lot of attention in order to understand him. You'll be pissed off after 1 or 2 minutes. So I'm talking about like really like talking Thai really good, which I can do. And after that, they get confident and they get to show themselves, which are playful, not caring much about the usual stuff. Like, where do you come from? Where do you stay? You know, you don't care. They don't care. The real stuff is what are we doing? How can we vibe together? And that's the real and most interesting stuff. Traveling can reveal who you are, what you actually need, and it's always a lot of fun as well. So I encourage a lot of people, especially young people, 18, 19, you know, just graduated, what we call in France the baccalauréat, 18, 19, 20, 21. Go travel. You don't know what you don't know what's life. You don't know how's life in other countries. Let's just explore it, experience it, in order to know better yourself, in order also to know better the world and the ways of the world. As before, when they say it in France, that's the expression, traveling is the best way to educate young people. So let's travel, guys. Let's travel.
If somebody's going over to Thailand, what are the 5 things they should bring?
Number one,
your balls.
Okay, number one, balls. Number two,
of course, take care of everything, you know, your personal documents, your passport and stuff.
Number three,
you don't have to take like some winter stuff. If you come into Thailand, take shirt, underwear, socks, take a lot. 6, 7, 8, 10, whatever. Number four, if you're a sport guy, in Phuket, there's a lot of sport going on. Tennis, soccer, baseball. There's some baseball as well. Take some sport gear, some sport stuff. Number five, yeah. Bring your dreams, your ambition.
Yeah.
You know, bring your dream, your ambition. Be ready to experience it.
Awesome, man. Thank you. Well, thank you for your time.
You can meet me at Lucky Bar in Chalong, Phuket. For the next year, I'll be here. You know, I'm happy to share a drink.
That's what he's got. So, till then, guys, I'll see you again.
Grown up in Thailand when I was a kid, from 2 to 6.